Hello my dear students, welcome to my class once again. Today we'll discuss the remaining part of voice. In my last class I discussed up to past perfect tense, how to change active voice into passive voice of past perfect tense. Today we'll discuss the future tenses. Then we'll go to imperative, then we'll go to interrogative, then imperative, then some exceptional sentences we'll do. The class is going to be a long one, so be patient and be with me till the end of the video. You can understand a lot. So let's start. Our last example was of past perfect tense. Now we are going to start from past perfect continuous tense. Past perfect continuous tense. Sentence will be what? Assertive. This is also we use very rarely. The use of the past perfect continuous tense is very rare, and the passive voice of past perfect continuous tense is also very rare. So first of all, we must know the formation of past perfect continuous tense. The formation of past perfect continuous tense is what? Subject plus had been plus verb ing. Subject plus had been plus verb ing. Subject plus had been plus verb ing. This is the formation of past perfect continuous tense. Now to change voice from active to passive, what to do? What is the formation of the passive voice of past perfect continuous tense? Object, then had been, then being continuous tense, that's why being, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will be in place of object. This is the formation of passive voice of past perfect continuous tense. First of all, we have to bring object in place of subject, then we have to use had been. Had been will be there in the sentence, so we have to use had been once more, then being, then verb 3, verb ing will be there, we have to use the third form of the verb, then preposition, then subject. So this is the formation of the passive voice of past perfect continuous tense. Let's practice a sentence. This is a sentence which is used very rarely in passive voice. They had been playing chess. They had been playing chess. This is a sentence of past perfect continuous tense. We have to change the sentence into passive voice. First of all, we must know subject, then verb, then object. So this is the subject because this is the doer of the action in the sentence. Subject, then had been playing is the verb, and object is what? What had been done by them. It is what? Result is what? Chess. So this is the object. So we have to follow the formation of the passive voice of past perfect continuous tense. What is this? We have to bring object first. Chess, it will not change because it is not there in that list of changing words. Chess, had been, then formation tells us to use being after that. Had been being, then formation tells us to use the third form of the verb. Chess had been being played, then preposition by, then they will become what? Them. Subject, when it will come in place of object, the word they will be changed into them. Chess had been being played by them. So this is the formation, this is the passive voice of the sentence. They had been playing chess. We followed the formation of the passive voice of past perfect continuous tense, and this answer has come, and it is right. But once more I am telling you, these sentences, past perfect continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense, and future perfect continuous tense, the passive voice of these sentences are used very rarely. But we must know how to change them. That's why we are doing. You must have the idea of that. Then the past tense is also finished. Now we are going to future tense. Assertive sentence, future tense. First one is what? Future indefinite. Future indefinite. Future indefinite tense. We must know the formation of future indefinite tense. What is the formation of future indefinite? The formation of future indefinite is subject plus shall or will plus verb 1. Subject plus shall or will plus verb 1. This is the formation of future indefinite tense. So, to change voice of future indefinite tense, what to do? We have to follow a formation. We have to follow the passive formation of future indefinite tense. What is this? One thing more. You write all the formation, all the passive formation of all the tenses. What I gave you here, you copy this one in your copy book, and then on the basis of that, you practice it again and again. So, the passive formation of future indefinite tense is what? Object will come first, then shall or will, then be, then verb 3, then preposition. Then subject will come in place of object. This is the formation of the passive voice of future indefinite. Object, then shall or will, then be, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will come in place of object. So, let us practice a sentence. I shall help you. I shall help you. So, we have to change the voice of this sentence. So, for changing voice, we must know the subject, verb and object of the sentence. So, here doer of the action is what? I. So, this is subject, verb is what? Shall help, and object is what? You. So, we have to follow the formation. What formation tells us? Formation tells us to bring object first. So, you. Then we have to use shall or will. Because of I, it was shall. Now with you, we have to use what? Will. You will. Then formation tells us to use be. You will be. Then third form of the verb help is what? Helped. You will be helped. Then we have to use preposition, mostly by. And here also with help verb, we have to use preposition by. Then I will be me. I, when I is the subject, when I take this one in place of object, then I will be changed as me. So, you will be helped by me. This is the formation. This is the passive voice of the sentence, I shall help you. We followed the formation. Formation tells us to use or to write the sentence this way. And this is the passive voice of this sentence. One more example, let us take. He will teach me. He will teach me. So, we have to follow the formation. Before that, we must know the subject, verb and object. Here the doer of the action is what? He. So, it will be the subject. Verb is what? Teach. Here the verb will be will teach, and object is what? Me. So, let's follow the formula, or let's follow the formation. We have to bring object first. Me will be what? I. With I, we have to use shall or will. With I, what to use? Shall. I shall. Then we have to use what? Be. And third form of the verb teach is what? Taught. T-A-U-G-H-T. I shall be taught. Then preposition by. And he will be what? Him. When will he bring him? He in place of object, then he will be him. I shall be taught by him. So, this is the passive voice of future indefinite tense. This is all about how we have to change a sentence of future indefinite tense into passive voice. Now, let's proceed to the next tense. Next tense is what? Future continuous. Future continuous tense. Future continuous tense. We must know the formation of future continuous tense. What is the formation of future continuous tense? We know it. Once again, I am telling you, subject plus shall be or will be plus verb ing. Subject plus shall be or will be plus verb ing. Subject plus shall be or will be plus verb ing. This is the formation of future continuous tense. Now, when we will be asked to change a sentence into passive voice of future continuous tense, we have to follow the passive formation of future continuous tense. What is the passive formation of future continuous tense? You have to bring object first, then object first, then shall be or will be, shall be or will be, then being, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will come in place of object. Object, then on the basis of this we have to use shall be or will be, it will be there in the sentence, and then for continuous tense we have to use being, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will come in place of object. So let's take an example how to change. This is the formation, passive formation of future continuous tense. These are also very rarely used, because future continuous tense, to know what will happen, what will be going on in future time, for that now we all must be fortune tellers. So these are very rarely used sentences. We must know the formations. Number one, he will be playing football. He will be playing football by this time tomorrow. So this is a sentence of future continuous tense where we are asked to change the voice into future, change the voice of the sentence from active to passive. For that we must know the subject, verb and object of the sentence. Here the doer of the action is what? He. So it will be subject, will be playing is the verb, and what will he play, this is what? Football is the object. Subject, verb and object we got, and this part, no, by this time tomorrow, it will remain as it is. We are not to do anything with this part. So now let's follow the passive formation of future continuous tense. What was that we wrote earlier? Let's try. Object we have to bring first. Object is what? Football. With football we have to use what? Will be. It is third person, so will be third person singular number. Will be football, will be. Then formation tells us to use being after that, and we also know that because it is continuous tense, and wherever continuous tense is there we have to use what? Being. Football will be being. Then third form of the verb play is what? Played. Football will be being played by, he will become what? Him. When we'll bring subject in place of object, if it is he, then it becomes him. So football will be being played by him. This is just one example I gave. You practice more, you have to do it again and again. I am not going to give you much examples because it will take a lot of time, and I have to discuss a lot of things about voice today. Next example, next tense is what? Future perfect tense. Future perfect tense. So future perfect tense, we know the formation of future perfect tense. Subject plus shall have or will have, then verb 3. Subject plus shall have or will have plus verb 3 is the formation of future perfect tense. Now when we'll be asked to change the voice of future perfect tense, we have to follow the passive formation of future perfect tense. What is this? First of all, we have to use object, then shall have or will have, then been. Perfect tense, been. Shall have or will have, then been, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will come in place of object. Object Then we have to use shall have or will have on the basis of the new subject, that means on the basis of the word which has come in place of subject. Shall have, we will use shall have or will have. Then we have to use been, as it is perfect tense, that's why been. Then verb 3 will be there in the sentence because it is perfect tense. Then preposition, then we have to bring subject in place of object. This is the passive formation of future perfect tense. So let's practice a sentence. I shall have done the work. I shall have completed the sum, or anything you can write present of future perfect tense. Now sentence we got, I shall have done the work. This is the sentence of future perfect tense, and we have to change the sentence into passive voice. So for that we must know the subject, verb and object. So here doer of the action is I, so it will be subject. Shall have done is the verb, it is future perfect tense, and object, the work has fallen on the work, this is the object. So we have to follow the passive formation of future perfect tense. What to do? We have to bring the object first, the work, and it was I, that's why shall have. Now it is the work, so it will be third person singular number, and for that we have to use will have, the work will have. Then formation tells us to use been, the work will have been. Then third form of the verb, it is there in the sentence, the work will have been done. Then preposition by, then subject will come in place of object, I will be what? Me. The work will have been done by me. This is the passive voice of the sentence, I shall have done the work. We just know the formation of passive form of any tense, that we can change the sentence into passive very easily. Now the last of all the tenses, this is what? Future perfect continuous tense. Here also all future tenses are very uncertain. What will happen in future times, it is not known to us. A future perfect continuous tense is the most uncertain thing. I only want to change the voice of that. Future perfect continuous tense. First of all, we must know the formation of future perfect continuous. What is the formation of future perfect continuous tense? Subject plus shall have been or will have been plus verb ing. Subject plus shall have been or will have been plus verb ing is the formation of future perfect continuous tense. Subject plus shall have been or will have been plus verb ing. If a sentence has been given in this way, that means in future perfect continuous tense, and we are asked to change the sentence into passive voice, then we have to follow the formation of the passive form of future perfect continuous tense. So let's see what is the passive form of future perfect continuous tense. First of all, we have to use object, then we have to use shall have or will have. Then been, perfect tense been, then being, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject will come in place of object. First of all, we have to bring object in place of subject, then we have to use shall have or will have, then it is there in the sentence, been, we have to write it, been, then it is continuous tense, that's why you have to use being, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject. This is the passive formation of future perfect continuous tense. I told you to write, you have to write these formations in your copy and you have to practice it. So let's practice a sentence of future perfect continuous tense, and we will change the sentence into passive voice. They will have been, they will have been preparing food. They will have been preparing food. This is a sentence of future perfect continuous tense, and we are asked to change the sentence into passive. So first of all, we have to identify subject, verb and object. So here doer of the action is what? Do, they, this is the subject, will have been preparing, up to this it is verb. Then what will they prepare? Food. This is object. Now we got subject, verb and object, and it has become easier for us now to change into passive voice because we know the formation. First of all, we have to use what? Object. Object is what? Food. It will not change because it is not there in the list of changing words. So food, it is third person. Once again, it was will have. Here also it will be will have. Then been, perfect tense. Then continuous tense, being, passive voice, continuous. Always we use what? Being. Food, will have been, being. But third form, prepared by, they will become what? Them. When it will come in place of object, they will become what? Them, because it is there in the list of changing words. Food will have been being prepared by them. Though they are very rarely used sentences of passive voice, but we must know the formation. Today, if it is not useful for us in our exams of class 9 and 10 or 11 and 12, but it will help us in our future when we will be appearing any competitive exams. Now it is over. SRT sentence is finished. Let's proceed towards interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentences. We have to change into passive voice of a sentence which is there in interrogative form. So interrogative sentence, we can very easily identify question mark would be there in the sentence. In my earlier classes, I told you interrogative sentences are of two types. One is what? Yes, no type question. Another one is what? WH type question. Yes, no type question means what? The question will be asked with the help of auxiliary verb. And WH type question, question will be asked with the help of word having WH. So first of all, we'll try to change the voice of yes, no type question. What to do first? To change a sentence into passive voice, and that if the sentence is interrogative sentence, what type of interrogative it is? Yes, no type interrogative. The easiest formula is what? First of all, we have to change the sentence into assertive. Changing the sentence into assertive, we can change the voice of that because we discussed elaborately about the rules of changing voice of assertive sentence. And when we change the sentence into passive voice in assertive, then what to do? We have to bring out the auxiliary verb from anywhere of the sentence to the beginning. Then it will be the answer of the question. Once again, I'm telling you, if we get a sentence yes no type question and we are asked to change the voice, the first of all, what we have to do? We have to change the sentence into assertive. Then we have to change the voice of that assertive sentence. After changing the voice, we'll get an auxiliary verb in the sentence, and we have to bring the auxiliary sentence, and we have to put it at the beginning of the sentence, and then we have to put a question mark at the end. Then it will be the answer. Very simple it is. If we practice twice or thrice, it will come. It will be very easier for us. Let's take an example. Are you playing football? Are you playing football? Question mark. We get a sentence. If we get a sentence like this, are you playing football? So this is interrogative sentence because we got sign of interrogation, that means question mark. Then we understood this is yes no type question because the question has been asked with the help of auxiliary verb are. Now what to do? We have to change the sentence into assertive. How can we change the sentence into assertive? Twice, thrice, if we practice it, changing the sentence into assertive by writing in our copy, then after that, no, after practicing, it will come to our mind. In our mind, we can do without writing. So here, let's write. Are you playing football? The assertive form of this is what? You are playing football. You are playing football. This is the assertive form of the interrogative sentence. You were playing football. Just what we have done, we have brought the subject first, then we have taken the auxiliary verb after the subject. It has become what? Assertive. Always it will happen. Whatever auxiliary verb is there, except do, did, it, does, then in all other cases, if you bring the subject first, and then after subject, if you take auxiliary verb, it will become assertive. Now we got an assertive sentence and present continuous tense. We have to change the voice of this sentence. You are playing football. So we know the formation of present continuous tense, how to use it in passive voice. Football is being played. Football is being played by you. This is the passive form of this sentence, assertive sentence. We have made it passive. Now, question is in interrogative form, so answer should be in interrogative form. That's why you have to make it interrogative. And we know the sentence in which an auxiliary verb is there, if we bring the auxiliary verb at the beginning of the sentence, then it will become interrogative. So here auxiliary verb is what? Is. So what to do? We have to bring is first. Is football being played by you? And then question mark, this is the answer of this sentence. So let's write. From here we are writing, we have got this sentence, and here we got auxiliary verb what? Is. So first letter it will be capital. Is, just we have taken this one directly. Is, then football, then everything will remain same in the sentence. Is football being played by you? Then question mark. This is the answer of this sentence. Is football being played by you? Very easy. Once more I am telling you, first of all we have to change the sentence into assertive. How to change into assertive? Just we have to bring subject first, then auxiliary verb, it will become assertive. After changing the sentence into assertive, we have to change the voice of that part, that assertive sentence. And when we'll get the passive form of that assertive sentence, what to do? We have to find out the auxiliary verb, and we have to bring it at the beginning of the sentence, and then we have to put a question mark at the end. It will become the passive voice of interrogative sentence, and interrogative sentence of yes no type. But here one problem will arise while making it assertive if the question is asked with the help of do, did, or does. Then we have to think something. We must know this. What will happen? See, do you know me? One question. Did he write the answer? This is another question. Does he play what carom? These are the three questions. If we get interrogative sentence having do, did, does, we know that these are auxiliary verbs, and we can directly understand this is a question, yes no type questions. And we have to, if we are asked to change the voice of this yes no type question, then what to do? I told you, know, to make it assertive. So in all other auxiliary verbs, what to do? We have to bring subject first, then we have to take the auxiliary verb. It will become what? Assertive. But here in these three cases we cannot do this. Do you know me? If you practice like that, then what will happen? You do know me. This is not the appropriate form. Did he write the answer? If you make it assertive, bringing subject first, he did write the sum. This is not the appropriate form. Then, does he play carom? If you bring subject first, then what will happen? He does play carom. This is not the appropriate form. To make these kind of questions assertive, what to do? Very carefully you listen. If you get a question having do, then we have to make it assertive. What to do? We have to omit do, and nothing will happen to the sentence. The assertive form of do you know me is what? You know me, full stop. Do you know me is what? You know me, then we have to give a full stop. If the question is asked in past tense using did, then how to make it assertive? We have to omit did, and we have to write the second form of the verb. Did he write the answer? The assertive form is what? He wrote the answer. Did he write the answer? Assertive form will be what? He wrote the answer. Why? Because we have omitted did, and we have written the second form of the verb. If a question is asked using does, and we are to make it assertive, then what will happen? We have to omit does and we have to add s or es with the verb, which will become assertive. Does he play carom? Assertive will be what? He plays carom. So when we will make the sentence into assertive, then it will be easier for us to change the voice, and after changing the voice, we have to bring the auxiliary verb first. In passive voice, always we will get auxiliary verb. I hope it is clear. Once again, I am telling you, if you get a sentence using do and we have to change the voice, so for that, what I said, we have to change the sentence into assertive. For changing sentence into assertive, what to do? We have to omit do, then nothing will change in the sentence. Then if the sentence, if the question is asked with the help of did, then we have to omit did and we have to use the second form of the verb. And if the question is asked with the help of does, then what to do? We have to omit does and we have to use s or es with the verb. This will be the assertive forms of these sentences. So let's practice a sentence of this kind. Do you like mango? Do you like mango? So this is an interrogative sentence and yes no type interrogative, and we have to change the voice. We have to change the sentence into passive. What to do? First, what I have said, we have to make the sentence assertive. So assertive will be what? You like mango. You like mango. So we have to change the voice of this. Mango is liked by you. Mango singular form, that's why is liked by you. We got the passive voice of assertive form of this. Then when we have already got the passive form of assertive, then what to do? We have to bring the auxiliary verb and we have to put it at the beginning. So is the auxiliary verb in this sentence. So we have to bring is first. Is mango liked by you? Then question mark, this will be the answer. Is mango liked by you? Question mark. From where we got? To make it assertive, what we did? We have omitted this one. The sentence remain what? You like mango, full stop. And we change the sentence. Mango is present indefinite tense. Mango is liked by you. We got the assertive of this. Mango is liked by you. Mango is liked by you. Assertive we got. Now we have to make it interrogative. Is the auxiliary verb. Just what we did? We brought this at the beginning of the sentence. Is mango liked by you? Now we have to put question mark at the end. It has become the passive voice of interrogative sentence, and that is an interrogative sentence of yes no type. One more example I am showing you using did. Did he do it? This is the question. This is an interrogative sentence and this is yes or no interrogative. How have we understood? Because auxiliary verb did is used here. So first thing, what we have to change the sentence into assertive. I told you, how can we change this sentence into assertive? We have to omit did and we have to use the second form of the verb. So did he do it? Assertive is what? He did it. He did it. Now we have to change the voice. It was done by him. Assertive, the passive voice of the assertive sentence is what? It was done by him. Auxiliary verb is what? Was. You bring was first. Was it done by him? Then question mark. Was it done by him? Question mark. This is the answer of this. So this is how we can change interrogative sentence into passive voice. Interrogative yes no type question into passive voice. Now we have to discuss about WH type questions. How can we change WH type questions into passive? Let's take an example. What are you doing? What are you doing? This is a WH type question. What to do? We have to be very clear. The word with which question has been asked, we have to keep this particular word intact as it is. So it is what. Now it has become our object. That means it has become our subject. Okay, what Because of you, we have used what are. Now, because of that, we have to use. What to use? What? Is or are. Present continuous tense or not? This is present continuous tense. Are, then verb ing, present continuous tense. And here, question, because of you, we have brought auxiliary verb first. Okay? Now, in passive voice, what to do? We have to keep this particular word intact, and on the basis of this particular word, we have to use what auxiliary verb. So, because of you, it was are. Now, because of what, it will be what? Is. What is. Continuous tense, what to do after using am, is, are, what we do? We use being. What is being? Then third form of the verb, do is what? Done. Then preposition by, then subject you will become you, because it is not there in the list of the changing words. In WH type question, to change sentences into passive voice, we have to keep the word having WH or the interrogative word as it is, and in passive voice it will act as the subject, and on the basis of that we have to use auxiliary verb. On the basis of this and on the basis of that tense, we have to use auxiliary verb. Then we have to follow the rules, whatever will come in our way on the basis of the formation of the sentence. Let's practice another one. Which pen do you like? Which pen do you like? So here, do is the auxiliary verb. Before do, up to auxiliary verb, how much is there? You have to keep it intact. So do is the auxiliary verb. Before do, what is there? Which pen? Okay. Then it is which, it is of which tense? Present tense. So we have to use am or is or are. Which pen? This is what? Third person singular number, we have to use what? Is. Which pen is. Then third form of the verb, which pen is liked. Then preposition by. Then subject, you will remain you because it will not change. It is not there in the list of changing words. Which pen is liked by you? So simple. Next. One more example, let's try. What did you do? What did you do last night? What did you do last night? So this is interrogative sentence. We have to change the voice of that. What to do? I told you before, auxiliary verb, the part having WH, we have to keep it. So here it is what, we have to keep it what. This is of which tense? Did. Did denotes, this is the second form of the verb, that means this is past tense. So we have to use what? Was or were. What is singular number, that's why was. What was. Then third form of the verb, this did is auxiliary verb to ask question. So what was, third form of the verb, do is what? Done. By subject you, it will remain you because it will not change, it is not there in the list of changing words. What was done by you last night? Question mark. This is the answer of this. My dear students, one thing very important we must know, whenever WH type questions will be there, we must get an auxiliary verb. If we do not get auxiliary verb in the sentence, then it will not be a question. That means after WH word, we have to get an auxiliary verb. What is your name? This is interrogative sentence, because after what we got what is. But what your name is, this is not interrogative. This is not interrogative. What are you doing? After what we got what are. This is what interrogative. What you are doing, this is not interrogative. So what did you do? Up to auxiliary verb, how much part is there? We have to keep it intact. Then on the basis of the tense of the sentence, we have to use auxiliary verb, then verb third form, then the rule will follow the rule of assertive sentence. This is all about how we can change a sentence into passive voice of interrogative sentence. Now, if a sentence starts with who, then what to do? This know what I said about what, which, how. Now, if a sentence starts with who, if an interrogative sentence and it's, if it starts with who, for changing voice of this kind of interrogative sentence, what to do? In place of who, we have to use what? By whom. Then we have to follow the sentence, how it is written according to them, according to that we have to do. Let's take an example. Who did the work? Very carefully you listen. Who did the work? So directly in place of who, we have written what? By whom. Okay, now we got the sentence is in past tense, so that's why by whom was. Okay, by whom was. Then the object we have to bring in place of subject first. No, by whom was the work. Then third form of the verb, done. By whom was the work done? Here by we are not to write, because we have written already in the beginning of the sentence by. If we get a sentence having who and we are asked to change the sentence into passive, then in place of who we have to use by whom directly. Then we have to follow the remaining part according to the construction of that. We have to change the voice. So you have written by whom, did it is in past tense, that's why you have written was. Then object is what? The work. By whom was the work. Third form of the verb, did is what? Done. Do, then it was second form, and third form of this is what? Done. By whom was the work done. And here after that we are not to write by this, that, because by already we have written at the beginning of the sentence. Now one more thing, if a sentence is asked with the help of whom, then what to do? If in active voice, if we get a question having whom, then what to do? If we get a question having WHOM, whom, then in passive voice, we have to use what? Who. Very careful. If in active voice, if we get a question having who, then in passive voice, what to use? We have to use by whom. And if in active voice, if we get a question having whom, then in passive voice, what to use? Who. So let's see. Whom do you like? Whom do you like? Okay. Now the passive form is what? Passive form of this question is what? We know that if active voice, then in place of whom we have to use what? Who. It is active voice because third form of the verb is not there. Preposition is also not there. So it is active voice. We have to change the voice of this sentence. So in place of whom we have written what? Who. Then it is present tense, is. Then third form of the verb, liked. Who is liked? Then by, then subject will go in place of object. Who is liked by you? Okay, one more example. Whom did he call? Question mark. So in place of whom, what to write? Who. Did, past tense, was. Third one of the above, called. Then by whom did he call? By, he will become him. Who was called by him? This is the passive voice of the sentence, whom did he call. I told you, if a question is asked with the help of whom, then in place of whom we have to use who, then we have to follow the remaining part. On the basis of that, we have to change. If a question is asked with the help of who, then we have to use what? By whom. And then we have to follow the remaining part. So this is all about interrogative sentences. I hope you have understood, and you have to practice this again and again. You write the sentences, what I have done, what I have given you as examples, you write them in the in your copy first. Then on the basis of them, you change the voice of the sentences, and it will be more helpful for you. More helpful, it will be very much helpful for you. Next, we are going to start imperative sentence. Imperative sentence. Imperative sentence, we know the sentence where we get what? Request, where we get what? Order, where we get what? Advice, where we get? Command. Order, advice, command, these things if we get, then this is what? Imperative sentence. One very important thing I am telling you, most of the times no imperative sentence starts with verb. Here we will not get any subject, and sometimes we will get an interrogative sentence where there is no object also. Subject is not there, and sometimes imperative sentence will be without objects also. Let's see. Do it. This is what imperative sentence. Order. It is an order or not? Do it. And it has started with verb. And here there is object. Do it. Another sentence. Stand up. This is also an order. And here there is, this is verb. And here there is no object. Here we do not get subject, but we got what? Object. But here in this sentence, we have not got subject, and object also we have not got. So sentence we may get in this way also. Sometimes we may get subject, sometimes we may get object without subject, and sometimes we may not get object even. Then also you have to change the voice. So what to do? For imperative sentence, imperative sentence with object, imperative sentence with object, we have to follow this formation. What is this? Let, then the object, let then object, then be, then verb 3. Let, we have to use let first, then object, then be, then verb 3. If there is no object, then what to do? I'll tell you later. This is the passive formation of interrogative imperative sentence having object. Let's take an example. Do it. Okay? So do is the verb and it is the object. So what to do? We have to write let first, let, then object it, then we have to follow this be, then verb 3 do, done. Let it be done. This is the passive of this sentence. One more example, let's take. Shut. Shut the gate. So what to do? Here shut is the verb, the guide is the object. So this is imperative sentence having object. What to do? We have to write let first, let, then object, let the gate, then we have to use what? Be. Third form of the verb shut is what? Shut, shut, shut. Let the gate be shut. Another. Don't make mistake. Don't make a mistake. This is imperative sentence. This is also imperative sentence. What kind of order? This is negative sentence. It is order. And here what we got? This is verb and object is there. Object is the don't make. This is the verb. And we got what? A mistake. This is object. So we have to follow that rule. Let, and here not is there, that's why let not a mistake. Let, then not, because of that you have used, then object, let not a mistake be, and third form of the verb make is what? Made. Let not a mistake be made. Let, because of negative form of order, we have to use what? Not, let not, a mistake, this is object, then after object we have to use be, we have used, then verb 3, make is what? Made. Let not a mistake be made. So if we get an imperative sentence having object, we have to follow this one. If it is in negative form, then we have to use let not. If it is negative, then let not. Now, let's come to the sentence where there is no object. If we do not get object in an imperative sentence, then what to do? As for example, you take stand up, come here, sleep, shut, this, then what to do? Object is not there in this sentence. So in these kind of sentences, we have to understand the meaning. If it is order, then we have to write it is ordered. It is not you are ordered, because in imperative sentence always the subject is what? Second form. When we order or when we advise the person whom we are speaking, and the person whom we are speaking, the person whom to whom the speaker is speaking is the second form, second person. And this is what? You. Second person is what? You. First person I, we. Second person you, you. So always the subject of imperative sentence is what? You, though it is silent. So when we get imperative sentence without object, then what to do? We have to use you are ordered to, you are advised to, you are asked to. You can write you are ordered to stand up, you are ordered to come here, you are ordered to sleep, you are ordered to shut. Or you can say you are asked to stand up, you are asked to come here, you are asked to sleep, you are asked to shut. If I say if I write a sentence having write nicely, so this may be a sentence, imperative sentence here. Some of you may consider it as order, or some other may consider it as advice. So you can say you are advised to write nicely. If you consider this one as advice, then you can write you are advised to write nicely. If it is order, then you are ordered to. If it is advice, then you are advised to. If it is request, then you are requested to. Then the remaining part as it is, we have to write. You are ordered to stand up, you are ordered to come here, you are ordered to sleep, you are ordered to shout, you are ordered to write nicely, you are advised to write nicely. Here you can use you are asked also. You are asked to stand up, you are asked to come here, you are asked to sleep, you are asked to shut, you are asked to write nicely. All are correct. If we do not get object in a sentence, we have to use you are ordered to, you are advised to, you are requested to, all those things. One more thing, if we get a sentence having object, and if somebody change the voice of this sentence having using you are ordered to, then what will happen? No problem. But the better thing is what? We have to use let. Let's see. Close the door, not that means shut the door. Shut the door. So here object is there, answer should be let the door be shut. The let the door be shut. If anybody writes you are ordered to shut the door, you are ordered to shut the door, we should not do this. We have to follow the rules. But if somebody writes you are ordered to shut the door, then it is not wrong, it will be correct. But the more appropriate answer will be let the door be shut. So we have to follow that one. We have to follow that one. We have to be very careful. If we get object with imperative sentence, then we have to write let, then object, then be, then verb 3. If there is no object, then you are ordered to, you are asked to, you are advised to, you are requested to, all those things. One more example. Tell him to sit. Tell him to sit. So here there is the sentence starts with what? Verb. This is imperative sentence. We are understanding this is an order and object is there. So we have to change the voice of this sentence using what? Let. So formation is what? Let. We have written let. Then object him. So when object is after verb, then it will remain same when we'll bring this one. That means when it comes first, then him becomes him. But if it is in the middle of the sentence, then it will remain same as it is. So let, then object is what? Him. Then we have to use what? Be, then third form of the verb. Let him be told, then the remaining part, to sit. So here a typical thing I told you, be careful. Him becomes he becomes him. When we bring object in place of subject, him becomes him. And when we take subject in place of object, he becomes him. But object will remain object, and we are not using this at the beginning of the sentence, then we are not to change. If it is him, then it will remain same. Him. We are not to write let he be told to sit. It will remain same. Let him be told to sit. So for our formation is what? Let plus object plus be plus third form of the verb. So we have done. Let him be told. Then the extra part to sit. It will remain same. Here we are not to do anything. Now I hope it is okay. Now let's practice another type of sentence. See, let him do the work. Now let him do the work. Now seeing let directly, we should not understand that this is a passive voice. The sentence of passive voice, we should not understand like this. In imperative sentence, from active we have changed into passive using what? Let. So just after seeing let in a sentence, we should not consider the sentence as passive, because in this sentence, in passive voice, we know we always use third form of the verb. Here there is no third form of the verb, so we have to understand this is not passive, this is what? Active. If we get sentences like that, active voice having let, then how to change? I'm telling you, let will remain same. Let plus object plus be plus verb 3 plus subject. So here let him do the work, let will remain same. Object is what? The work. Let the work. Then be, let is used, that's why be, let the work be. Third form of the verb, do is what? Done. Then preposition, then verb 3, then preposition, then subject. So let the work, object is what? The work. Let the work, then be, then verb 3, do is, third form of the verb, do is what? Done. Let the work be done. Preposition by, and him will remain him. Let the work be done by him. We have to be careful. If we get let in a sentence, seeing that, we should not think the sentence as passive voice. If it is passive voice, then be will be there in the sentence and third form of the verb will be used. If be is not there, third form of the verb is not there in the sentence, and let is there at the beginning, then we should not consider the sentence as passive voice. Actually it is active voice. And how to change? I have shown you, let plus object, let, it will be there as it is. Then we have to bring object, then be, then third form of the verb, then preposition, then subject, and it will not change. How it is, it will remain same. Let, object, be, verb 3, then preposition, then subject. Now before going to other part of voice, other branches of voice change, I want to tell you that we can change voice of optative sentence also. Optative sentence, but they are very rarely used. You don't waste your time, you just see how to do. And we can change even extraordinary sentence voice also. I'll show you one or two examples, I'll show you, and you can understand. Let me write an example. me, you, be happy. This is optative sentence. Or another one. Long live our hero. Or may God bless you. These three sentences we got. We will practice these three only. Let's see how. After the sentence, we know it is prayer or wish. Prayer or wish or curse. Prayer, wish or curse. So using these words, we can change the voice. May you be happy. May you be happy. This is what? Wish. So it is wished that you be happy. It is wished that you be happy. Long live our hero. It is prayed that our hero should live long. May God bless you. It is prayed that God bless you. It is prayed that God bless you. So using this, it is wished that, it is prayed that, it is cursed that, we can change the voice of optative sentence. It is wished that you be happy. It is wished that our hero should live long. And it is prayed that God bless you. It is prayed that God bless you. Similarly, exclamatory sentence also. Using it is exclaimed that, we can change the voice. This you just keep in your mind, or you write this. It is wished that, it is praised that, it is cursed that, to change the voice of optative sentence. Then we have to keep the remaining part as it is. Exclamatory sentence also, how to do exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence, to change voice, but very rarely these sentences are changed into passive voice. S-E-N-T-E-N-C-E. Exclamatory sentence. How to change? Example, I am showing you. What a fool I am. What a fool I am. What a fool I am. So how to change the voice of this? It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. What a nice building the Taj is. The Taj is. Simply, you use what? It is exclaimed that the Taj is a very beautiful building. The Taj is a very nice building. What a nice building the Taj is. It is exclaimed. It is exclaimed like narration. It is exclaimed that the Taj is, present tense, the Taj is very nice. The Taj is a very nice building. The Taj is a very nice building. To change voice of exclamatory sentences, what to use? It is exclaimed that. It is exclaimed that. And because of what, because of how, we have to use very or great. Very or great. Here we have to use, before full we have to use great. Very full we cannot say. And here before nice we cannot use great. We have to use very. So what a fool, passive voice is what? It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. And what a nice building the Taj is. It is exclaimed that the Taj is a very nice building. It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. And it is exclaimed that the Taj is a very nice building. Those passive voices are very rarely used. We should not waste our time. We just write this to change optative sentences into passive. How to change? We have to use what? You are wished that, you are prayed that, or you are cursed that. And to change exclamatory sentences into passive, we have to use what? You are, it is exclaimed that. It is exclaimed that. An optative sentence, it is prayed that, it is wished that, it is cursed that. And exclamatory sentence, it is exclaimed that. It is exclaimed that. Then remaining part will remain same. Only in exclamatory sentence, what to do? We have to use after a, that is after determiners, after article, we have to use very or great, very or great on the basis of this adjective. What it will be? On the basis of this adjective, we have to use very or great. Here it will be great and here it will be very. It is exclaimed that I am a great fool. It is exclaimed that the Taj is a very nice building. Okay, now let's proceed. This you keep in your mind and keep this in your copy also. You write this in your copy, note it down in your copy. After this sentence, giving star marks, you can separate them. After this sentence, it is wished that, it is prayed that, it is cursed that. Assembly sentence, it is exclaimed that. Then you have to use very or great. Now we are coming once again to the rules. Now if we get a sentence starting with it is time, then how to change the voice of this sentence? If the sentence is it is time to start the class, it is time to start the class, and we are actually changing the voice of this sentence, what to do? For this kind of sentences, you be careful, you write how to change the voice of this. We must know a formation. It is time plus for plus object plus to be plus verb 3. This is it is time plus for plus object plus to be plus verb 3. If we get a sentence in active voice having it is time and we are asked to change the sentence into passive, then what to do? It is we have to follow this formation. It is time plus for plus object plus to be plus verb 3. So if this is the sentence, then what to do? We have to keep it is time first. It is time, then rule says us, or the formation tells us to use for. It is time for, then the object, the class, it is time for the class. Then what to write? To be object, then to be, it is time for the class to be. Then verb 3, start verb, third form is what? Started. It is time for the class to be started. It is time for the class to be started. If we get a sentence in active voice having it is time, then we have to change the sentence into passive voice in this formation. It is time plus for plus object plus to be plus verb 3. So it is time, this sentence, passive voice of this sentence, it is time, then for, then object, the class, then to be, then third form of the verb start is what? Started. Now let's discuss something about quasi passive voices. Quasi passive, that means half passive these are. Honey, example, you see honey tastes sweet. Honey tastes sweet. This is a sentence. And this is active voice because no auxiliary verb and third form of the verb is also not used. This is active voice. But you see, honey tastes sweet. Honey is the subject, taste is the verb. Now, can honey taste itself? No, honey cannot. Honey is a non-living object and it cannot taste itself. So these kind of sentences, when we'll get subject is not the doer of the action, subject is not the doer of the action, but it is shown in the sentence as the doer of the action, then these are known as what? Quasi passive voices. And how to change it? Very simple. Honey tastes sweet, so it will be what? Honey, present tense, that's why, is sweet. When we understand honey is sweet, simply seeing honey, can we say this is sweet? No, after tasting, no. So when honey is sweet, when It is tasted. Honey is sweet when it is tasted. Okay. One more example. If I show you. The book reads well. The book reads well. This is also active voice. And here the subject is what? The book. Verb is what? Read. Can the book read itself? Can the book read? The book cannot. But here in the sentence it shows that the book is the reader or the book is the subject. So this kind of sentence are known as what? Quasi passive. And when we are asked to change the voice, then what to do? We have to write, we have to do this one like earlier one, the book present tense. That's why is, the book is well. When we understand this one, the book is well or good, when it is read, when it is read. The book is well when it is read. And here we, if we use the book, sounds well when it is read. No need. The book is well when it is read. It is okay. Another one we see. In winter season, what happens? No, the blanket feels soft. The blanket feels soft. Whether the blanket feel itself? No, it cannot. But here it is shown. So it is what? Quasi passive. How to change the voice of that? The blanket is soft when it is felt. When it is felt. These are some of the examples of quasi passive voice. So I hope you have enjoyed the class, you have understood. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment box. And if you cannot find the answer of any sentences, you cannot change the voice of this sentence, you can write it in the comment box. I'll help you, I'll make you understand. With that, I'm going to conclude my class. Thank you once again.